Bonjour les enfants, j'espère que vous allez bien. Je suis très super et très contente de pouvoir continuer à lire en français. Lire en français. Qui se rappelle de ce que lire veut dire? Who remembers what lire means? Read, that's right. So today we are reading. Nous lisons. En français, nous lisons en français. Répétez après moi. Nous lisons en français. We read in French. Ok, prenez votre papier, votre petit paquet qui a tous les papiers du livre « La petite maison dans la prairie ». Ok, et nous allons lire ensemble. Page 14. Page 14. Who remembers what number that is? 14. 14. Très bien. 14. Et nous allons commencer à papa. OK? This is where we will start. À papa. Rappelez-vous de suivre avec votre doigt. Votre doigt. Remember to follow using your finger. Good. And pratiquez à répéter en même temps que moi. Try to repeat at the same time. Try to say the word at the same time I say it. And I will try to say it slowly. Okay, so you can practice trying to read in French. At the same time I'm reading, okay? Okay, so let's start. If you want, right before you start, take a few minutes. Miss Margaret can pause. Et prenez quelques minutes pour lire les questions, to read the question, okay? Before you start, so when you read, you kind of have those questions fresh in your mind so you can remember, oh, she asked about this. And then you can write your answer or wait till the end to write your answer. Maybe it will be better. Actually, that's what we're going to do. I will read and then I will pause so you guys can answer or Miss Margaret can pause. Okay? All right. Papa promit à Laura de lui montrer un papoose quand il serait arrivé dans l'ouest. Qu'est-ce que c'est qu'un papoose? Lui demanda-t-elle. Un papoose, c'est un petit bébé indien. Brun, lui répondit-il. Papa promised Laura to show her a papoose when they will arrive to the west, in the west. What is a papoose? She asked. A papoose is a little Indian baby, all brown, he answered. Okay, so I'm going to pause here, or Miss Margaret, you can pause, and you can answer the first question. Okay. Ils roulèrent longtemps dans les bois enneigés avant d'atteindre la ville de Pépin. Marie et Laura y étaient venues une fois, mais la ville leur parut avoir un aspect très différent ce jour-là. La porte du magasin et celle de toutes les maisons étaient closes. Les barrières étaient couvertes de neige et les petits enfants ne jouaient plus dehors. de grands cordeaux de bois étaient empilés à l'intérieur des barrières. On ne voyait que deux ou trois hommes bottés, coiffés de bonnets de fourrure et vêtus de manteaux écossais aux couleurs vives. Okay. They drove for a long time in the woods covered with snow before arriving in the city of Pépin. Mary and Laura had already come there once, but the city seemed to be so different this day. The door of the store and those of all the houses were closed. The fences were covered with snow and the little children did not play anymore outside. Big logs of wood were piled up inside the fences. They could only see about two or three men who had big boots on and who had big fur hats and were dressed with Scottish jackets with bright colors. Scottish jackets are very, very warm clothing because it's very close and very cold in Scotland. Maman, Laura et Marie mangèrent du pain et de la mélasse dans le chariot. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, so I will pause here and you can answer the second question. And you can answer in English, but if you know a couple words in French, go ahead and write them, insert them in there in French. So like if you want to say, Dad said to Laura, you can say, Papa, now you know how to say that. And so, you know, little words like that, that you know. Okay. Maman, Laura et Marie mangèrent du pain et de la mélasse dans le chariot. Les chevaux, le maïs de leur musette, tandis que papa allait échanger ses fourrures au magasin contre tout ce dont ils auraient besoin pour le voyage. Ils ne pouvaient pas rester longtemps en ville, car il leur fallait traverser le lac le jour même. Mom, Laura and Mary ate bread and molasses in the wagon. The horses, the corn that was in their I can't remember how you call this, musette. They had corn there that they could eat throughout the day. While Daddy would go and exchange his fur in the store against all that they would need for this long voyage or trip. They could not stay very long in the city because they had to travel through the lake and go all over the lake that very same day. Okay, so I will stop here so you can answer question 3 and question 4. 3 et 4. L'immense lac s'étendait, plat, lisse et blanc, jusqu'à l'horizon que bornait un ciel gris. Les traces laissées par les chariots à la surface se poursuivaient si loin qu'on ne pouvait deviner jusqu'où elles allaient. Elles semblaient ne finir nulle part. Papa engagea le chariot sur la glace dans les traces de ceux qui l'avaient précédé. Les sabots des chevaux rendaient son son mat alors que les roues crissaient. Le bourg, derrière eux, s'amenuisa de plus en plus et la haute bâtisse du magasin finit par n'être plus qu'un point. Il n'y eut plus autour d'eux qu'une immense étendue où régnait le silence. Laura se sentit mal à l'aise. Papa, pourtant, était sur le siège du chariot et Jack au-dessous. Elle savait que rien ne pourrait lui arriver tant que papa et Jack seraient là. Au bout d'un très long temps, le chariot grimpa une rive de terre et à nouveau il y eut des arbres. Une petite maison en rondin se dressait au milieu de ces arbres. Laura se sentit soulagée. Nul ne vivait dans cette petite maison. C'était un endroit où l'on pouvait camper. Cette cabane avait quelque chose de bizarre, avec sa grande cheminée et ses grossières couchettes fixées contre les murs. Mais une fois que papa eut allumé un feu dans la cheminée, il y fait chaud. Cette nuit-là, Marie, Laura et bébé Carrie dormirent avec maman dans un lit improvisé sur le plancher, près du feu. Pendant que papa dormait dehors, dans le chariot, pour le garder, ainsi que les chevaux. Ok. I'm going to stop here and you can answer number 5. Actually, you can't answer number 5 yet. You have to wait till we're completely done to go back and answer number 5, okay? So, put number 5 on hold. And I'm going to translate what I just read. Papa engaged the chariot on the ice. And I'm going to translate what I just read. The huge lake was the huge lake was spreading flat, smooth and white all the way up to the horizon where a gray sky started. The traces left by the wagon on the surface kept on going as far as we could imagine where they would go. It seems like they never stopped. Papa engaged the wagon on the ice. In the prints of those who had gone before him. The hoofs of the horses made a The hoofs of the horses made the wagon sound very flat. At the same time, the wheels would hiss like that. The city behind them, or the little village behind them, was becoming smaller and smaller, and the biggest store finally became just a dot on the horizon. There was only around them a huge flat lake where silence reigned. Laura started feeling bad. Even though Daddy was still sitting on the front of the wagon and Jack right under him, she knew nothing could happen as long as Daddy and Jack were there. After a long time, the wagon finally arrived on land. And finally, there were trees again. A little house made out of logs was in the middle of these trees. Laura was Laura felt better. No one lived in this little house. It was a place where we could camp. This cabin had something very bizarre about it, with this big hole chimney. Once Daddy had started a fire in the chimney, it started warming up and felt cozier. That night, Mary, Laura, and baby Carrie slept with Mom in an improvised bed on the floor near the fire, while Daddy slept outside in the wagon to keep it safe, as well as the horses. Au milieu de la nuit, un bruit surprenant éveilla Laura. On aurait dit un coup de fusil, mais c'était tout à la fois plus sec et plus prolongé. Elle l'entendit encore et encore. Marie et Carrie dormaient, mais Laura ne se rendormit qu'après avoir entendu maman lui souffler dans le noir. « Rendors-toi, Laura, ce n'est que la glace qui se brise. » Le lendemain matin, papa remarqua. « Il est heureux que nous ayons traversé hier, Caroline. » Je ne serais pas surpris si la glace se rompait aujourd'hui. Nous avons traversé tard dans la saison et nous avons eu de la chance que la débâcle n'ait pas commencé quand nous étions encore au beau milieu. Cette idée m'était venue hier, Charles, lui répondit doucement maman. Cette idée n'était pas venue à Laura auparavant, mais à présent, elle y songeait. Elle se demandait ce qui se serait passé si jamais la glace s'était rompue sous les roues du chariot et qu'ils se soient tous enfoncés dans l'eau froide au milieu de ce vaste lac. Tu inquiètes quelqu'un, Charles, prévint maman. Papa serra très fort Laura contre sa large poitrine, et là, elle se sentit en sécurité. Nous voilà de l'autre côté du Mississippi, s'écria-t-il en l'étreignant tout joyeux. Qu'est-ce que tu dis de ça, ma petite chope de cidre doux à moitié bu? Est-ce que ça te plaît d'aller dans l'ouest, là où vivent les Indiens? Laura reconnut que ça lui plaisait, puis elle demanda s'il se trouvait déjà au pays des Indiens. Il ne l'avait pas atteint, pourtant. Ils étaient au Minnesota. Ok, so this part I'm going to translate and you'll be able to answer actually 6, 7, and 8 and 5 as well. Okay, and that will be the end. In the middle of the night, a surprising noise woke up Laura. She thought it was a rifle. She thought it was a rifle, but it was drier and even longer than that. She listened and heard it again and again. Mary and Carrie were sleeping, but Laura could not go back to sleep until she heard Mommy tell her, whispering her to her in the night. Go back to sleep, Laura. It is only the ice that is breaking. The next morning, Daddy noticed. This is a good thing that we have crossed over the lake yesterday, Caroline. I would not be surprised if the ice would break all today. We have crossed over very late in the season and we haven't had the chance, and we have had the chance that the lake did not start breaking before when we were in the middle of it. This idea came to me yesterday, Charles, answered quietly Mommy. This idea did not come to Laura before, but now that she thought about it, she was wondering what would have happened if the ice had broken up under the weight of the wagon and that they all would have fallen in the cold water in the middle of this vast or this huge lake. You are worrying someone, Charles, told Mommy. Daddy pulled Laura close to him against his chest, and there she felt safe. We are finally on the other side of the Mississippi, he said, pulling her against him again, all happy. What do you think of that, my little half pint of cider, half drunk up? That's the little nickname he gives her. Are you happy to go in the West where the Indians live? Laura recognized that she was happy about it. And she asked if they were already in the country of the Indians, but they had not gotten there yet. They were in Minnesota. Okay, so you should be able to answer all your questions. Vous devriez pouvoir répondre à toutes vos questions. Okay, répondez à vos questions and that is all for today. Au revoir les enfants!